Hi, I'm Tina McDonald, part of Spellbinders Design Team. Today we're going to be using the 5x7 Grate Effect card front to create, no, not a card, but a scrapbook page. The card fronts are fabulous because they have both a border and a decorative insert. Today we're going to be using only the decorative insert portion. I've cut a 12-inch strip of plain paper, just the width of my insert here. And I'm going to hold it in place on top of the paper using a piece of low-tack tape. Now place it paper side up onto the junior base plate, cover it with the junior metal shim, followed by the pink embossing plate, and then we're going to run it through the grand caliber machine. Now I want to extend this into a 12-inch strip. I'm going to place my paper over the die template, lining up the last line of what was already die cut with the template. Cover with the metal shim and die cut as we did previously. Now you have a 12-inch strip to work with. I've gone ahead and trimmed off the edges so that I have just the decorative portion here for my page. Now I've trimmed it down the center to create two strips, and then I've also trimmed off three lines of the decorative portion. Then I've lined it up askew slightly on my page so that it gives it a little bit of an artistic element. Now take a strip of red patterned paper as well as a strip of black cardstock and place them over the Grate Effect die as well. It doesn't have to thoroughly cover it. Now we're going to die cut this again using the metal shim and the pink embossing plate. Run these through your grand caliber machine. Now go ahead and pop these out using Spellbinders tool in one. Now swish all these to the side and we can begin to assemble our page. Now onto the background of my page, I've taken and flicked on a little bit of black irresistible texture spray. I've also added a small portion at the bottom of the Grate Effect that we had trimmed off. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start filling in some of these blank spots inside the Grate Effect with some of the black and red pieces that we cut out just a moment ago. So according to where you're going to be placing your photo, we're going to place some of the black pieces in. We're going to place some red. We're going to leave lots of them blank as well. And then I've also used some of the teal color that I cut out from my initial cut, and I'm going to fill in some of those as well. So you can go ahead and do that in whatever fashion you'd like. You can put as many or as few. I've matted my photo onto black cardstock and then again onto a piece of white corrugated cardboard. And now I'm going to continue to position around my photo. I've added my title, and now I've got some tiny red star sequins that I'm going to place around my page as well. These add another fun touch of shimmer and another little bit of shape to it as well. I love the look of journaling strips, so I've gone ahead and printed my journaling on the computer and trimmed it out into strips, and I'm going to add that to the left side of my page here. I've also die cut some of the arrows from the Shoot die set, and we're going to add these just around our title, just to give a little extra accent. To finish off my page, I've added a couple of strips of black and white striped paper. I'm going to add one 3/4 of the way across the top, and again 3/4 of the way across my bottom left side. This just adds a little bit of contrast with the patterns that we're using. And that is our page. Thanks so much for watching today's video. Remember, just because a die is often used for a card front does not mean it's not able to be used for a scrapbook page. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day.